So I think it's time to harvest these potatoes, and I figured I'll bring you along. It's one of the more exciting harvests because there's really no indication whether there's a single potato in there or if these bags are loaded with potatoes. So yeah, let's take a look. First thing I'm gonna do is just snip these vines. So let's start. Well, that's pretty much all I got. I believe only one plant produced from here. It's kind of disappointing. This was a 20-gallon bag. So, yeah, we have a bunch more. So I'll check out the rest. It didn't look like the plants actually had anything in them. Yeah, I mean, this guy has tiny little potatoes, but they never really grew, so oh well. I'll go dump this cart and we'll take a look at the next one. Well, so there it is. That's the big potato and grub harvest of 2016. A couple of things I noticed. I started with initial about 5 inches of soil, and then as the potatoes grew, I put more soil. And people say that they will run roots on the side, just like tomatoes do because they're in the same family, but mine never did. The bottom part of the soil was really compacted, so that probably had a lot to do with the growth. The fact that I only had this much soil for the plant to grow in probably also didn't help. So I think next season I'm going to use a lot more sand or some coarse material to keep the soil very, very loose. And I'll probably just plant the whole thing, fill the full bags with soil, and just see what happens. Also, in this area over here, there is only about, I would say, 4 hours of sun. But unfortunately, that's how my backyard is. I have a lot of shade, so I really have no choice. And yeah, I mean, it was fun. I still got a little bit. We'll probably have for a few meals and probably 4 or 5 trips for fishing. But yeah, see you next time.